Yo yo, I'm Trigil Kristen. About a year ago, we had a medical card system introduced into the UK called the Cancard. And because it's been about a year, I wanted to make a video talking about my thoughts on the Cancard and how everything's kind of gone over this last year. Because a lot of people asked me to make an update video on it, so here is the update video. Quickly before we get into this video though, we need to have a message from our sponsor of the day, Medicated Mice! Yo, Medicated Mice is a new NFT and metaverse project where their end goal is to try and have like a weed map style experience, but in the metaverse. And for right now, it's kind of just an NFT project. It's super easy to check out the roadmap over on their website, and their Discord is thriving right now with over 10,000 active members. Well, not only just 10,000 active members, but 10,000 really friendly active members that are always in the Discord, able to chat with pretty much anyone. It's always super friendly whenever I go in there. They're on track right now for a full sellout, but they're offering 100 whitelists to you guys right now for the next 48 hours. But it is only the first 100 people to use my link that's in the description or the pinned comment. So if you want to try and get that whitelist, make sure you're one of the first 100 people to click on the pinned comment link or the description link, and hopefully you'll manage to get that whitelist. So thank you, Medicated Mice, for sponsoring this video, and thank you guys for supporting the sponsors, and let's get into this video. So about a year ago, the Cancard got introduced into the UK, and if you're not from the UK, you might hear people who have medical conditions will be able to go and get medicine, right? But that is not what the Cancard is. So let me explain for anyone who doesn't know what the Cancard is. So going even further back to 2018, this is when the Home Office announced that you're actually able to get private prescriptions in the UK. So that meant if you needed a medical cannabis prescription, all you really needed to do was go private. Sounds pretty good, right? But at the time, the only place you could actually go to a clinic and speak to a doctor and like get this private medicine was on like the Channel Islands. And not only that, but it was really, really expensive as well. So the Cancard system was made so people who were eligible for a prescription could prove that they were eligible for said prescription, but didn't necessarily have the money or the means to be able to get one. And like I said before, back in the day, these prescriptions were expensive and they were hard to get. Now, luckily, because of everything that's gone on in the last 2 years, you now do all of your appointments over FaceTime, so you don't actually need to go to the Channel Islands or go to one clinic that exists in the middle of nowhere. You can just do it all from home. Nowadays, in 2022, it's a lot easier to get a prescription, like I just mentioned. It's also a lot cheaper, and generally, the availability is just there now. But the Cancard system got introduced about a year ago, and regardless of the availability or regardless of price, the Cancard system is still there for people to be able to use. And some people still to this day can't get medical cannabis. Like, you know, they can't get private, they can't afford it. And as I kind of discovered the side of prescriptions after I discovered the Cancard, I mean, originally, my main thought process was, I guess I don't really need the Cancard anymore, because the whole point of the Cancard is to prove that you are eligible for a prescription, but you don't really have one. But then afterwards, I then got a prescription, so surely I shouldn't need the Cancard, right? Wrong. Well, technically, you wouldn't be wrong if you thought that, because technically, that is the case. But in this last year, I have been stopped a stupid amount of times by police, and every single time I've been stopped, you know, I've shown them my prescription and I've had to go through like a long process of proving my prescription is real and like going through all this stuff with the police telling me, no, the prescription doesn't exist and all this stuff. And then at the end of it, they end up proving my prescription is real and then I get to leave. But there's one thing I just missed out there, which is on every single one of these interactions, you know what I have been asked for? My Cancard! But the Cancard is there for if you don't have a prescription. But yeah, every single time I'm told by these police officers, oh, you know, if you have one of them Cancard things here, we wouldn't have to go through, you know, your whole prescription and like prove that it's real. We'd be able to just see your Cancard, see your ID and go, sweet. And I think at the beginning when Cancard first came about, everyone was told that the police were going to be briefed on it, and then there were big conflicting reports on whether the police had been briefed or whether they haven't been briefed. And I can tell you from like over 6 interactions with police, they have been briefed, because every time I have had an interaction with the police, they have asked me for my Cancard as a prescription holder, which to me just seems really crazy, especially seeing as I lost my Cancard, right? I've got to admit it here. I lost my Cancard ages ago, probably like 8 months ago, not long after I got my prescription. But I didn't think I needed to get another one, because at this point, I had a prescription. Why would I need a Cancard? A Cancard proves that you're eligible for a prescription for your medical intent. And the police have been briefed that if you have a Cancard, they probably shouldn't do anything because it's not going to go anywhere in court, right? But surely I don't need that because I've got a prescription. But like I said, every single goddamn time I have an interaction with police, they tell me the same thing every time. Do you have the Cancard? Oh, this could be over in 5 minutes if you had a Cancard. So, at this point, it's now been a year of the Cancard. And I think I can well and truly say that at least the police forces I've dealt with have indeed been briefed about it. And in fact, a lot of police forces care more about a Cancard than they do about you having a prescription. And it's easier for you to have a Cancard than it is to have a prescription, which seems a bit backwards to me. I'm not complaining, but just seem a little bit odd. So people, I want to know in the comments down below, how has your experience been? Do you have a prescription? Do you have a Cancard? Have you experienced the same thing as me where they ask you for a Cancard rather than your prescription? Or have you had it the other way around? I would love to know because I'm really interested in whether everyone is having a similar kind of experience as I am, because I do find it very strange that all these police know the Cancard exists, yet they don't know that you can get a prescription. But the whole point of having a Cancard is that you're eligible for a prescription. So yeah, it is a very, very strange one. I don't really know what else to say other than that here. I think I've got everything off of my mind that I really wanted to talk about. So people, if you like my videos, make sure to hit the like button and the subscribe button just down here. I upload videos like this all the time. I do have more of the drug iceberg coming out very, very soon as well. So stay tuned for that. Make sure to hit the notification bell so that way you can come into the premieres every time I premiere a YouTube video. You also get notified, you know, in general, every time I upload. And also I stream on Twitch every day at 9 p.m. during weekdays and 11 p.m. on weekends. So people, I'll see you soon in a bit. Peace.